Alright, welcome to this screencast on vectors. I want to start out with just saying a quick word about why we're even talking about vectors in this course. The reason is that we're going to build up some tools related to vectors, matrices, and more generally the field of linear algebra in service of curve fitting or model fitting, right? So the basic idea is, you know, you might have some data, and you might have in mind some curve that best fits that data. You'd like to find that curve given a particular functional form that you might choose, you know? And once you choose the form of that function, you have to find the parameters of the function to make it best fit the data. You can use tools from linear algebra to do that. That's why we're talking about this whole thing, and that's where you'll get to by a few screencasts from now. For now, let me just start out by telling you what a vector is. And a vector is really just a pair of coordinates, right? So sometimes we'll write it x, y like this, or sometimes we write it in the form of what's called a column vector, like this, x, y. So, you know, for example, I can have the vector 1, 2, or we might write it as 1, 2, like this, okay? Now, geometrically, what a vector is it's an arrow with a tail and a tip. Okay, and the key is that the tip is always x units to the right and y units above the tail, right? So let's say I want to kind of visualize geometrically this vector 1, 2. I'm going to start here. The 1 means go 1 unit to the right of where I started. The 2 means go 2 units up. And then I connect those things with an arrow, and that's the vector 1, 2. Negative numbers, well, negative to the right or negative above means left and down, right? So, you know, if I have the vector 3, negative 2, that means go 1, 2, 3 units over and 2 units down. That's this vector here. Okay, now something else you should realize is that a vector is actually sort of defined independently of where it starts. So if we're talking about the vector 1, 2, that's this vector here, that is considered to be the same vector as this vector, right? Because they're both vectors that end 1 unit over and 2 units above where they started. So even though they're sort of placed, they originate in different points in the plane, this vector and this vector, we often will think of as being the same vector. The next thing I'd like to introduce you to is what's called scalar multiplication. So algebraically, what this means is that you have a vector x, y, and you multiply it by some constant, and you get a new vector, and that constant c multiplies each element of the vector, right? Cx, cy. So for example, 2 times the vector 1, negative 2, is the vector 2, negative 4. Okay, let's draw that geometrically, okay? So I'm going to draw the vector 1, negative 2. That's this vector here. Okay, then I'm going to draw the vector 2, negative 4. That's 1, 2 over, 1, 2, 3, 4 down. That's this vector here. And what you see is that you get a copy of the original vector, but that's twice as long, right? So the scalar multiple either stretches in this case, or if it's smaller than 1, and I'll do that example in a minute, it shrinks the original vector. Also, it flips the vector if c is less than 0, if c is negative. What do I mean by that? Well, let's do another example. Let's take the vector 2, 2 and multiply it by the scalar multiple negative 1 half, right? Well, of course, that's equal to minus 1, minus 1. So let's draw this now. I get the vector 2 over and 2 up. That's the vector 2, 2. When I multiply it by the scalar multiple negative 1 half, I get negative 1, negative 1. So you see, I get a vector that points in the exact opposite direction. The opposite is the minus sign, and it's half as long as the original vector. That's the 1 half. Negative 1 half flips it, multiplies the length by a half. Let's talk about vector addition. algebraically, if you have two vectors, x, y, and z, w, and you add them, then what you get is a new vector where the first entry is the sum of the first entries in the original two vectors, so you get x plus z, and the second entry here is the sum of these second entries, y plus w. It's kind of intuitive. Okay, so for example, if you had 1, 3 plus 2, negative 1, you would get 1 plus 2 is 3 on top, and 3 minus 1 is 2 on bottom. Geometrically, the way I want you to think about this is as a set of instructions for walking around, okay? So here's what this means. When you see 1, 3, you can visualize the vector 1, 3 over here, right? This isn't a very straight vector, but that's okay. 1 unit over, 3 units up. Then you see 2, negative 1. That means take the place you just walked to up here. You walked 1 unit over and 3 units up. Starting from there, go 2 units to the right and 1 unit down, right? 2 units to the right and 1 unit down. That's this vector here. Then you ask yourself, where do you end up? Well, you ended up here, and if you check, this resultant vector is 1, 2, 3 units over from your original location and 2 units up. So it's the vector 3, 2. Right? So that's the way to visualize vector addition as a set of walking directions. All right, so we could do one more example if you want. We could do minus 1, 1, plus minus 2, minus 2. And that would be equal to 1 minus 2 is minus 3 and minus 1. Visually here, we started at the origin, then minus 1, 1 means 1 left and 1 up. So we were here. From that point, we were supposed to walk 2 units left and 2 units down. 2 units left, 2 units down. And then we ask, what's our final location? That's this vector here, which if we count on our graph, is the vector negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 1. All right, that's vector addition. The last thing I want to introduce you to in this screencast is called linear combination. Linear combination just combines what we've already talked about. It combines scalar multiplication with vector addition. So if you have two vectors, x, y, and z, w, what linear combination means is just multiplying each one by some constants and adding them together. Like some constant times x, y, plus some other constant times z, w, okay? So to give you an example, you know, we could take negative 1/2 of the vector 2 minus 2 plus 3 of the vector 1, 2, and we would find that this is equal to, well, when I multiply by negative 1/2 here, I get negative 1, 1. And when I multiply by 3 here, I get 3, 6. And when I add those things together, I get negative 1 plus 3 is 2, and 1 plus 6 is 7. Okay, so that's what linear combination means. And geometrically, you can again kind of think of this as walking directions. So I'll do another example, but I'll do it geometrically. Let's take two steps of the vector 1, 1, and let's take, let's see, say three steps of the vector minus 1 and minus 2. I think that'll work out on this picture. So taking two steps of 1, 1, well, first I'm going to find 1, 1. Okay, here's the vector 1, 1. And I want to take two steps of that vector. So there's 1, and then there's 2. I end up here. Then from there, I want to take three steps in the direction negative 1, negative 2. So negative 1, negative 2, that's down here. Then I have to do it again. Another step of negative 1, negative 2, that puts me down here. And then another step of negative 1, negative 2, that puts me down here. And then if I want to count, The final answer looks to be negative 1, right? Because I'm 1 unit to the left of where I started, and I'm 1, 2, 3, 4 units down. So negative 1, negative 4. All right, so we've come to the end of this screencast, and I want you to ask yourself if you can explain what a vector is, and if you can explain both algebraically and geometrically how to do the following things: scalar multiplication, vector addition, and linear combination. Thanks for listening.